Dr. Esther Trufan, and in this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to use the red cabbage indicator solution to test the pH of a variety of household chemicals. So for this experiment, I'm going to use 3 test tubes, and to transfer the materials, I'm going to use 3 pipettes. I'm going to use individual pipettes for each one. But if you are sharing one pipette among the experiments, just keep in mind that between tests, you need to clean those pipettes and then move on to your next test. I will also need a separate pipette to transfer my indicator solution. So now for the materials that I will be testing today. First, I'm going to test some lemon juice, and I transferred some of it into this cup. I'm also going to test some vinegar, and I transferred some of it in this cup. And I will test baking soda, which I dissolved some in some deionized water in this third little cup. And then finally, I need my indicator solution. I labeled all my test tubes to make sure that I don't accidentally confuse things. So for the first one, I have it labeled as vinegar. I will draw up some vinegar and transfer it into the test tube. And then I will use my pipette that will be dedicated to the indicator solution to draw up some of the indicator. I can add more, but the color is no longer purple, but rather a different color. And I need to keep in mind that this is vinegar and its color is going to be pink when interacting with the indicator solution. Next, I am going to look at my lemon juice. I will take a clean pipette, draw up some lemon juice, and transfer it into the test tube. And then transfer some of the indicator solution in there. And I can see that there has been a color change yet again, and this time it went towards a pink color. Finally, I am going to test the baking soda solution. I will draw up some of my saturated baking soda in my pipette, transfer it to the test tube, and then transfer the indicator solution into it. And it changed color yet again. If I were to test the pH of water, it would likely be the same color as my indicator solution, except maybe a little lighter because I am diluting my indicator solution with more water that was already in. Should you like to try other substances, just look around the house or the laboratory and find other materials. And for each of them, treat it similarly. Add a couple drops to a test tube, and then add about a pipette full of the indicator solution. That should give you enough of a response to determine whether your material is acidic, basic, or neutral.